Today we're going to look at the Helly property for hypergraphs. First, let's introduce two terms to help us state the Helly property. An intersecting family is a hypergraph whose pairwise intersections of edges are all non-empty. From another perspective, it's a hypergraph whose line graph is a complete graph. Note that an intersecting family can have as little as one edge, for that edge's intersection with itself would be non-empty. In fact, any hypergraph with only one edge will be an intersecting family under our definition. Next, if we have a hypergraph H with a partial subhypergraph H prime that is an intersecting family, we say that H prime is an intersecting subfamily of H. Here's an example of a hypergraph H, and here is an intersecting subfamily H prime. A star is a hypergraph with a single vertex incident to all edges in the hypergraph. Here's an example of a star, with vertex B being contained by every edge in the hypergraph. Notice that all stars are intersecting families, since if there's a vertex incident to all edges in the hypergraph, all pairwise intersections of edges will contain at least that vertex. However, not all intersecting families are stars. The hypergraph shown here is an intersecting family that is not a star. Also, intersecting families cannot have an empty edge, as that edge would not have a non-empty intersection with any other edge. We're now ready to state the Helly property for hypergraphs. We say that a hypergraph is Helly if all its intersecting subfamilies are stars. If we want to show that a hypergraph is not Helly, all we have to do is find a single intersecting subfamily that is not a star. Note that if our hypergraph has no intersecting subfamilies, which can only occur if all edges are disjoint, then our hypergraph is Helly by default. Also, any triangle-free ordinary graph interpreted as a two-uniform hypergraph is Helly, as the only intersecting subfamilies would be spanning subgraphs containing just two edges, where those two edges share an endpoint. Any one of those intersecting subfamilies must be a star, as the shared endpoint would be present in all edges of that spanning subgraph. Let's look at another example now. Is this hypergraph Helly? It's not Helly because there's an intersecting subfamily that is not a star. Now you might be wondering, what would happen if we define intersecting subfamilies to be subhypergraphs only and not partial subhypergraphs, meaning we allow ourselves to remove both edges and vertices? If we then define the Helly property the same way, which is that all intersecting subfamilies must be stars, then we arrive at a stronger condition than the conventional Helly property. All hypergraphs satisfying this new, stronger condition satisfy the Helly property, but not all hypergraphs that satisfy the conventional Helly property would satisfy this stronger condition. Here's an example of such a hypergraph. Notice that it's Helly because the intersecting subfamilies are all stars when we define intersecting subfamilies in the conventional sense. But with our new definition of intersecting subfamily, this is also an intersecting subfamily, but clearly it's not a star. This is one reason why the partial subhypergraph-based definition of intersecting subfamily is nice. It leads us to a more general property. Moving on, let's look at a theorem about Helly hypergraphs. The theorem is, if a hypergraph H is Helly and has no empty edges, then the transversal number of H equals the click covering number of its line graph. To review, the transversal number is the size of the smallest set of vertices that contains a vertex from each edge in the hypergraph. This is known as a transversal. While the click covering number is the size of the smallest click covering in a graph, which is a set of clicks in a graph whose union is the vertex set of that graph. The line graph of a hypergraph is an ordinary graph whose vertices correspond to the edges of the hypergraph. And where two vertices are adjacent, if their corresponding edges in the hypergraph have a non-empty intersection. To see why our theorem is true, first, notice that informally, a clique in the line graph is an intersecting subfamily in the hypergraph, provided our hypergraph had no empty edges, as empty edges would correspond to one clique in the line graph that are not intersecting subfamilies in the hypergraph. Note that when we say that a clique is an intersecting subfamily in the hypergraph, we really mean it's the set of edges of that intersecting subfamily. Now, because we assume our hypergraph is Helly and has no empty edges, we can say that any clique in the line graph corresponds to not only an intersecting family, but a star in the hypergraph. This means we can identify, with each clique C in the line graph, a single vertex V sub C in the hypergraph that's incident to all the edges in the hypergraph that were members of C in the line graph. As a result of the fact that we can choose such a hypergraph vertex for each clique in the line graph, if we have a clique covering of size n, which means we can exhaust the vertices of the line graph with n clicks, then we can choose a set of vertices in the hypergraph of size less than or equal to n, such that every edge in the hypergraph is incident to some vertex in our set. In other words, we can create a transversal in the hypergraph based upon our clique covering of the line graph, and this transversal has at most n vertices. Now all this shows is that the transversal number is at most equal to the clique covering number of the line graph. Why are they exactly equal? Because for any transversal, we can build a clique covering of the line graph with at most as many cliques as there are vertices in the transversal. If we have a transversal T, then for each vertex V in T, there exists a clique in the line graph, C sub V, composed of the edges that are incident to V in the hypergraph. In other words, this clique in the line graph is just a set of edges in the hypergraph incident to V. Since T is a transversal, the union of each of these sets has to exhaust all the edges of the hypergraph. So the union of these cliques in the line graph has to exhaust all the vertices of the line graph, meaning that the set of these cliques is a clique covering. This means the line graph's clique covering number is at most equal to the transversal number. Together, this means that the line graph's clique covering number equals the hypergraph's transversal number. To demonstrate this theorem, we'll construct the transversal from a line graph clique covering, and then we'll construct a clique covering the line graph from a transversal. Let's use this Helly hypergraph together with its line graph. We're going to use the clique covering defined here, which only uses maximal cliques. We have three cliques in our clique covering. Notice that because our hypergraph has no empty edges, every one of the cliques in our clique covering corresponds to a star in the hypergraph, meaning for each of our line graph cliques, there's at least one hypergraph vertex incident to all hypergraph edges in our clique. We're going to build a transversal in the hypergraph by choosing such a vertex for each clique in our clique covering. For the first clique in the clique covering, clique E sub 1, E sub 2, E sub 3, we can choose vertex A. For clique E sub 3, E sub 4, we have two choices. Both vertices G and F would work. So let's choose G. For clique E sub 5, we have to choose H, as it's the only vertex incident to the single edge in the clique. The set of these vertices, AGH, is a transversal in our hypergraph. Next, let's go in the other direction, using a different Helly hypergraph. First, find a transversal in our Helly hypergraph. AE is a transversal. Now, for each of the vertices in the transversal, list the set of edges incident to that vertex. A is incident to edges E sub 1, E sub 2, and E sub 4. E is incident to edge E sub 3 and edge E sub 4. Note how these sets of edges are not necessarily disjoint. However, their union is the vertex set of the hypergraph, because the vertices we built these edge sets from was a transversal. Each of these sets is a clique in the line graph, and together the sets are a clique covering of the line graph. To summarize, an intersecting family is a hypergraph where all pairwise intersections of edges are non-empty. An intersecting subfamily is a partial subhypergraph that is an intersecting family. A star is an intersecting family where there is at least one vertex incident to all of the edges. A hypergraph is Helly if all its intersecting subfamilies are stars. And for Helly hypergraphs without empty edges, the transversal number equals the clique covering number of the line graph. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe and click the like button. Have a great day.